You know, I thought our team really battled, but obviously it doesn't take a rocket scientist to understand our lack of size was trouble for us all night. Give Weaver a lot of credit. He came out and really shot the ball well early and got separation. I don't think they missed in the first probably 7 or 8 possessions. But I was proud of our guys. We called back into it. That shot at the half kind of got their momentum back. After the momentum was in our way. In the second half, we missed a lot of bunnies around the rim. I don't know if that had to do with fatigue or just the fact that we had a lot of length in there. So, you know, it's a good stepping stone for us. I felt, you know, Weber and Montana, the two teams, we've always tried to model ourselves where we need to get to. I think our guys in that locker room learned tonight, you know, we're just not quite there. We're close. We're just not quite there yet. Just the speed of the game, the physicality, and the length. But, our senior group right here, I'm extremely proud of the group of seniors we've had. They've 2 years in the league. They've run 27 games. They've been in 3 conference tournament title games over a 4-year career, and they've done it the right way. They're just a class act of young men, and they're just disappointed that we couldn't get it done tonight.
Questions?
Brian, the start, obviously you didn't need that kind of start for Weaver. Were they getting good looks or defensively?
Against these guys, you got to pick your poison. They're good inside. They're good outside. And we felt because we're undersized, we had to try to take away the inside play, try to double down low, and they made shots. They made 3s early, and they were wide open shots. It was just we didn't rotate quick enough and try to put in a scheme to stop that, and just we didn't have enough rep. Obviously, if we had some practice time on it, we probably would have been a little bit sharper, but with the short turnaround, we just didn't have enough time to get confident in it.
The depth factor tonight, too, with Jamal?
Well, obviously, we're losing. Jamal was pretty much out. And not having Shuler, those 2 of our top 7, 6 guys. And that's being seniors and being a big part of what our success has been in the past. It's unfortunate because you want to be able to go in a game like this full strength, and we weren't full strength. And it's not an excuse, but Jamal's our point guard, our leader, and Shuler's our glue guy. So we definitely need those things, and it showed tonight.
Aaron, can you kind of sum up? Nobody's played more basketball at UND than you, and in quite a career for you.
It was a fun ride. I mean, just coming out and playing night in, night out with the group of guys that I had all 4 years, it was a fun experience.
The start, did that surprise you tonight by Weaver?
You could kind of expect it just because it's at home, and I'm pretty sure they were all hyped up, and they executed their game plan better than we could on that defensive end.
Brian, what's the future? What's the future hold right now?
We obviously just got to continue to make steps forward. These guys have taken a step every year. Took another step this year. We won, if you count the tournament games, 14 games. Last year we won 13. We got a winning record. That's probably, we had an extremely tough non-league schedule. But I think it was the toughest in the league. So we did a great job. Just now we got to focus on our recruiting and continue to add. It's going to be tough to replace these guys. They've won a lot of basketball games. They took us through the transition. They did it with great character and integrity. So now we're going to have to continue to, I think it's year 2 in the league. We know what kind of bodies we need to add, what kind of athletes we need to add. So it's, you know, our focus now is going to have to turn to recruiting and continue to add to the void that's going to be left by these guys.
Questions?
Everybody good?
Thanks, Phil.